Viveka Vairagya comes from clarity of understanding of Vedantic teaching. Very, very clear. It should not be words. Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, all that. It should not be words. How it applies to me, where it applies to me, we have to be very, very clear. Absolute clarity. That's finished. Then you don't need Vedantic text also. That's why it is said, Vedaha Bhavanti Avedaha. Okay? You have seen, no? Dattatreya. Right? Dattatreya has four dogs following him. Why? Why not five dogs? The dogs are Vedas, four Vedas. The Vedas are like dogs following Jnani. Okay? Whereas Ajnani will follow Vedas like a dog. You understand? Jnani when he speaks, it is Veda. Ramana, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa when he speaks, it is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa Veda. Vachana Veda. Okay? D.V. Gundappa when he speaks of Mankutimma, it is a Veda, Upanishad. Mankutimma Nakkaka is Upanishad. Okay? Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, even he speaks of words, it becomes Upanishad, Veda. Vedas follow Ajnani like the four dogs, and Ajnani follows Vedas like a dog. Okay? So beyond certain point, once you get a clarity, over, the job is over. Roadmap is required till you reach the destination. After that, roadmap is not required. Vedas are like roadmaps. Right? Once you get a crystal clarity, Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, Sarpradnan Brahma, Sarvam Kalvita Brahma, after that, over, the job is done. No, I still want to do it. That means after reaching the destination, so I want a map. Why?
To go back.
The problem here is you can't go back. It's one way ticket, no return ticket.
Actually, if you have reached the destination, then you should be aware that you should not be asking for the roadmap at all.
Correct, I'm saying the necessity of the roadmap false, I'm saying. Vedaha Bhavanti Avedaha, that's what Upanishad say. Okay, I don't say that. Upanishad say the whole point you have reached there is you understand, okay, what is there in that year? It's all over. That clarity has to come. That's why vidyate rade granthi chidyate sarva samshaya tasmin dushte paravare. This is the Mundaka Upanishad. Vidyate rade granthi chidyate sarva samshaya tasmin dushte paravare. That means vidyate rade granthi means ego drops. How does ego drop?
Ego is not there.
Ego is not there. You understand? Ego is not there. Chidyate sarva samshaya. All doubts are gone. Aham Brahmasmi is gone, Tattvamasi is gone, God is gone, doubt is gone. Now you know exactly what it is. Shiyante tasya karmani. There's no karma for him because there's no karma, there's no doer.
There's no bhokta karta.
Tasmin drishte paravare. One who sees paravara means parabrahma. Who is that parabrahma? I. You cannot see Parabrahma, you can be Parabrahma. Parabrahma cannot be object. Okay, you can recognize, see God only as I. No, I see God, then you are not, then you are, there's a gap.
Separation.
Separation is there. Okay. Experience are two types. One is experience of nothingness. Experience of nothingness only, I am there, the consciousness is experience itself as bliss. That's in deep sleep, in meditation. Okay? Then experience of somethingness is there. Something means world and all. So I'll make experience in three categories. Experience of nothing, experience of something, and experience of many things, everything. Okay. So first experience is called I am nothing. Where do you see the experience? Deep sleep and meditation. And that is called Parabrahma. Bliss only is there. Okay? Then second experience is...
You can see it even in deep shock. Smashana Vairagya.
Yeah, yeah. In the deep shock, even coma. All those things are Parabrahma only.
Ishtena jar jeev.
That's Vairagya. Right? ಅದು ಮದುವೆ ಆದ ಕೂಡ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಅದು 40-45 years ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸಹಸ್ರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಾನು ಯಾರಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಬದುಕಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್. ಮದುವೆ ಆಗಿ ಎರಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಅದು ಟ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಬೇಗ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತು. ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಲರೇಟೆಡ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್.
ಅಶ್ವಿನಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಎರಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ ಎದ್ದು
ಸೊ there is experience of I am nothing, which is actually what you call as, this is in deep sleep or meditation, I am nothing, okay, it's called bliss, parabrahma, infinity, right? So then you see the world, there is something, okay,
many things,
there are many things, okay, then there is called I am everything, okay. This I am everything comes with the aham brahmasmi and sarvam khalu idam brahma, clarity on that, right? Aham brahmasmi sarvam khalu idam, clarity has to come. Till that time I am everything doesn't come fully, okay? So here this something is appearing and this nothing is appearing, which of this is true? This is appearing and disappearing. Okay, what appears and disappears is not real, it's mithya. That's what last class is about. Okay, it's like movie, appears and disappears. What is real is I only. Tell me which point of time you didn't have experience of I. Deep sleep, you don't have experience of I, it didn't exist.
Conscious,
you, did you sleep or not?
Yeah, that experience.
Did you sleep or not? You only had good sleep. Who knows I had a good sleep?
I.
So you didn't express, but experience was there. Don't confuse the expression with the experience. The moment you say, I am having a good sleep, then good sleep is gone. Right? Not only your sleep is gone, your wife's sleep is also gone. She is not sleeping. Are we clear? And which of these is spiritual experience? All three. So this is spiritual experience, spirit experiencing itself as elephant, itself as world, itself as wall, itself as plan. That's called Shakti. It's mithya, unreal, but it's experiencing.
So that is the elementary awareness or consciousness, whatever.
Why is elementary?
Because it is mithya, right? So I.
Mithya means temporary.
Yeah, it comes and goes.
Comes and goes. But comes and goes from whom? I. This I experience, was it missing any time?
No.
It's always there.
It's always there, background. That's Parabrahma. Or Sadashiva. This is Shakti. Okay? And this is a realization. Now in between this Shiva and Shakti, what happened is the Jiva came, the society child came. Everything started crying, Prabhu only is teaching. Okay, Prabhu is having a joy. Prabhu is happy. Parabrahma is left, Shakti is left. That's called Jiva. And the Jiva is a product of what? The language, the society. Okay. So that guy came and started claiming everything. Oh, I have to do enough sadhana to realize Shiva. Oh, this is all material world. I want to go to spiritual world. I am a spiritual person. My dear, where is the spirit and matter end? Where is the beginning of spirit and where is the beginning of end of matter? Everything is divine. There is no spiritual life. There is no material life. There is only divine life. Okay. The one who claims the spiritual life into material life and divine life is called society child. Because society child is a product of language. In language only divine life and material life is there. If there is no language, there is no divine life and material life. Okay. Where is Pakistan? Where is India? God has not put a boundary. Okay. It's in the map only. It's in the human mind only. The human mind becomes silent. There is no divine experience and spiritual experience. Matter and spirit. It's all one. That oneness you have to reach. That's meaning of Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi, if you stop, you are stopped halfway. Okay? It has to come to a stage, Sarvam Kalida Brahma. That can happen only when the society child becomes silent. Or you learn how to ignore the society child. You cannot beat this society child into silence. You don't have to.
So that center one is Aham Brahmasmi.
Aham Brahmasmi. I am everything. Right? There are three experiences. So, it's time lunch now. Now this we'll take in the next class.
Big story.
Next hackathon. Next
hackathon. Every experience is spiritual experience.
See, the
but the claimer of experience is Jiva.
Jiva. And Jiva is a product of society.
Society.
Got it? Every experience is divine experience, because experience to recognize consciousness is required. Without consciousness, no experience is possible. That's why Brahmarpanam, Brahmahvihi, Brahmagno, Brahmanavatam. Brahmaivatiyana gantavim, Brahmakarma samadhin. Everything is offering to Brahman. But in between Jiva came. Oh, I only ate a cup of coffee. I only did the work. Khaas agai. Are we clear? The life is neither material nor spiritual. It's only divine. That can happen only when you realize Aham Brahmasmi and Sarvam Khalida Brahma. If you do part realization, that's what happens to many monks. They say it's material life, they'll say. Then they're saying Aham Brahmasmi, they're trying to go. Okay? The moment you realize Sarvam Khalida Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi together, then you say everything is divine only. 50% will not help you.
So three things are coming in all these three.
That I have told you in a different way. Right? We'll go for food.